2012 started with big news. Exobionics in Berkeley, California, saw my video and invited me out to test pilot their bionic exoskeleton. I gathered the McKee team and we headed out to the Bay Area to enjoy some of the sights and foods that make it so famous. From the Bay Bridge, Alcatraz, and Fisherman's Wharf, to the Natural History Museum's Rainforest and Aquarium, we were not disappointed. Monday, January 23rd brought us to our destination in Berkeley, California. I went with Jen, my physical therapist, to the final screening for the robot. Meanwhile, the family got to watch Exo show off a little bit.
You guys excited to be here?
Yeah!
Where are we?
Exobionics.
Where?
Berkeley, California.
Berkeley, California. Y'all having fun?
So fun. Yeah, we're going to Alcatraz today.
Going to Alcatraz today?
We're like in third grade here.
So what do y'all think of his e-legs over here?
It's pretty cool. I took a picture of it.
Took a picture? Yeah.
Yeah, pretty I've cool. always said he would walk again, but I didn't.
Yeah, would you think Dad'd be doing this 10 years ago?
No. Again. There's walking and then there's walking. And we'll take whatever we can get, right?
You said walking.
Yes,
you should say bionic.
There's walking cool. And then there's bionic walking.
There we go.
Bionic walking is pretty cool. You just outwalk us all and blow off just exhausted, like, down. We're so tired.
Yeah.
Be like the next Kardashian.
He's gonna get it turbocharged or something.
He's gonna be in his avatar, and I'm gonna be in one of those, what are they called, those scoot around things.
A scooter, like the Lady of the Stars game.
A rascal.
No, what's it called?
Like the Lady of the Stars
the hover
game.
Hover round.
Yeah, you gotta get a hover round, Mom. There you go.
Just on Hebo with Dad. Yeah.
Exo was ready, and so was the family. I brought the whole family with me because we had struggled together, and I felt we should celebrate together. They were all very happy. Me, on the other hand, I was a little tense.
You passed?
All right.
Grab you a video from Jen.
Yeah.
Hey, luckily, Jen gave me a multiple choice test. So
I did. He answered correctly.
So. A chip.
I don't know about the chip.
As Jen started strapping me into the robot, I could tell my pulse was up and my adrenaline was pumping. It'd been almost 10 years since a motorcycle accident left me as a T5 complete paraplegic. I'd stayed active though, swimming 3,000 yards a week, and had developed more and more core strength over the last couple of years. It was time to see if all that had paid off. No words were needed for this final embrace, but the emotions were huge. Okay, it's showtime. As I stood up and looked around, the view was amazing. Jen was suddenly dwarfed by my 6-foot frame. When I looked down, I saw my feet and not my belly.
Here we go. There's one.
Man, this is great.
My first steps were amazing. To see my feet and legs moving was some tremendous motivation.
Oh man.
I found myself with a death grip on the walker. My brain is telling me I can't stand and walk, so I was bracing really hard against the walker.
Oh, man.
After some coaching and relaxing, I found that I was fully supported by the Exo robot, and the walker was just for minor adjustment.
How'd it feel about watching Dad walk for the first time?
Pretty awesome.
Yeah?
Pretty awesome. I forgot how tall he was.
Oh, I know.
Get a video of him turning.
I got it. Stay back a little bit. Lean to
your right. Yeah, hold on. I'm trying to keep him in the view. Get the legs in there.
There you go, Dad.
There you go, Dad. You got it.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
No problem.
Okay. Go on to the right. And up.
Jenny that told me that.
Yeah, that's what they all say. Shocker, right? Some for it a
little. When I was walking, I found that it took my entire concentration. Someone asked me a question, my walking would get sloppy and Jen would correct me. I literally couldn't walk and chew gum at the same time. At the end of day one, Exo was worn out and so was I.
So how do you feel now?
I feel good.
Feel good? You sore?
I will be.
You will be.
I'm 53 years old. You know?
How was the, Mom, get another video.
Okay.
How was the, how was, was it hard in your arms? I mean.
Well, I was making it way too hard because I felt like, I was having to put all my weight.
That's why I kept grabbing your arms.
Yeah,
once it looked you were just, some of your arms would start shaking.
Yeah, so relax, and finally I just figured out I'm just using that to just barely
kind of balance a little bit, yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's all it was, and I think she was pretty impressed, but I was getting, how far to lean and how far forward, and that's why I was doing it.
I'm surprised you get those shooting spasms sometimes.
Yeah,
like, I'm surprised you don't have anything like that.
Nothing like that.
No? How do your legs feel right now?
I was feeling it quite a bit, my quads.
Uh-huh.
Not so much down below, but like right now, my legs are just crazy.
Throbbing a little bit, yeah.
Day two brought some Texas swagger as I showed up wearing my Texas bow tie.
Unbelievable.
Some seafood, sourdough, and a good night's sleep helped me get right back into the rhythm of walking. No longer fighting, I was learning to shift my weight and actually had some moments of rather fluid walking.
You feel like your shoulders are a little more relaxed today? Shoulders and arms a little more relaxed? Yeah, you don't look like you've got the death grip. Bill says it's weird, just don't know where, when he was first paralyzed, he's like, I don't know where my body is. I don't know where my legs are. It's just creepy not to know where your body is. And then you're like, have to move it, to transfer. He's like, it's too scary, I can't do it, I don't know where I am.
By the second day, the sensory overload had dissipated, and I was learning to balance and lean so that I actually developed some rhythm in my walking. Man, could I have some fun with this at home. My mind was racing with the new possibilities that the future might hold, not only for myself, but for all of the injured that need a glimpse of hope. How lucky am I to be here right now? Thanks, Annie. This broken man is walking into the future with EXO. Praise be to God.
It's like he's got constant movement now. It's not step, stop, step, stop.
And so my time at EXO concluded. New accomplishments and new goals were in front of me. Once again, I stood as the head of my household and was able to hug the ones I loved. Big thank you to my Texas inventors, Adam and Katie, and to my favorite California PT. Thanks, Jen. You all get a standing ovation.